sorry about the time delay.
Mr. Chairman, dear colleagues, thank you for the kind introduction. Let's change the theme. I'm a doctor without knife. I'm a specialist for physical medicine, rehabilitation, and pain management. And I would like to invite you to a journey about shockwaves, especially in the neurological rehabilitation. You know shockwaves to treat calcified shoulders, hot spurs, tennis elbow, and so on. That for me and this evening wouldn't be interesting. Why doesn't it work? Help! Help! I'm constipated, it doesn't work. I'm constipated. Next slide, please. Ah! Well, we know two kinds of shockwaves. We know those which are real shockwaves. That means very, very short, with relatively high energy, only 0.3 microseconds long. That means it's very short. And then we have worldwide a false labeling that are the so-called radio shockwaves. They are very long in comparison with a focused one. Very long, and you have less energy because they are hurting. If you take more energy than you would do with the focused ones, then the patient wouldn't come again. He stays at home and wouldn't refuse to be treated. So, shockwaves. You see, it's a physical phenomenon. This is a shockwave after a nuclear explosion. These are other shockwaves. We don't need that in clinic. This is a shockwave treating a baby's foot. The baby is suffering from polyradiculitis, polyradiculoneuritis, and Guillain-Barré syndrome. And we can apply shockwaves, but with low energy. So, just to have a look on it, the little chapter we know from the Eurodes, that is the energy between 0.4 and 4.0, and pain management, it's lower, and we need and use the stimulation and cellular regeneration, and we don't apply more than 0.2 millijoule per square millimeter energy flux density. Oh. This is a device we use, and with the standoffs, this is only silicone, and with the standoffs we can manage the depth of the focus in the tissue. So we have a maximum of a focus of 65 millimeters, and then we have a medium focus with 45 millimeters, and then we have the focus directly at the other side of the handpiece. So what could, at least theoretically, could be useful for nerve repair? That is the angiogenesis managed by the endothelial vascular growth factor, the neurogenesis, the lymphatic flow, and the differentiation and migration of stem cells. There are worldwide billions of dollars are spent in stem cell research, shockwaves produce or provoke stem cells. And these growth factors and the stem cells need energy to produce. And that is done by the energy production via endothelial nitrogen oxide. That is the therapy, the energy source. That means all this sounds good for nerve repair. And all this is upregulated by shockwaves, by focused ones. And what's really important? Important is, if you, for instance, treat hip necrosis in young men and you examine the blood serum and you are searching those growth factors I described, then you can see those growth factors not in the hip but in the blood serum for more than 4 weeks circulating. That means that is systemical, it's not local. They treat it locally, they provoke there the sprouting of capillaries, but the growth factors remain in the body. What do we have now, until now, in animal models? If you crush in a rat the femoralis nerve or sularis nerve, then you have, with shock waves, a recovery of the nerve lesion in the rat of 50% the time you have expected. The same is if you are crushing the medulla spinalis, the spine, then you have in the rat a recovery with shock waves in 50% of the time. If you in red provoke a infarctus, a brain infarctus, then the recovery will be quicker and the volume of the infarctus will be more or less than expected. And what do we have in humans? In humans, we have the treatment of muscular stiffness, soft contractures, and spasticity in general, in children and adults. And the spasticity may be of different origin. We don't treat diseases. We only treat symptoms. We have in minimal consciousness, in vegetative state, I did it some years ago, and in Berlin, in the Charité, they have the same results. In the coma remission scale, we have in general a gain of 100%. That means if a patient started with 7 points in the coma remission scale, then we will have about 14, 15 points after the treatments. And we have also a relief of pain, paresthesia, in the distally symmetrical polyneuropathy, diabetics, alcoholics, and toxic. In preparation is a study about the improvement of cognitive abilities in Alzheimer's disease and in Parkinson's disease. The Alzheimer's disease we do with Professor Weissteiner from the University of Vienna, and he treated 15 patients, and I treated 15 patients, and the results are similar. and very positive in the follow-up of at least 3 months. That is the official investigation. But I continued over 1 year, and the patients held the results. So we have always an immediate effect. That means an effect of the sympathetic tonus. Right side, that means this right foot, has been treated with shock waves and the capillaries are open. In spastics, the feet are cold and humid, moisture is, the sweat is sometimes dropping. And the right feet is treated, the left feet was not treated. That means it's immediately. On this, the right side, you see the control right in the upper photos, and in the photos below, you see a treated rat after ligation of the femoral artery. And this is in an animal model, but we use it in some locations in Japan and in Germany, at least in cardiology, for the revascularization of infarctus necrosis of the heart in humans. You see, the sprouting of the vessels, that takes time. It's always the problem that we have seen yet. Where have I have to aim on this device? Because sometimes it's working and sometimes it doesn't. Okay, well, for me the essential of what I said is shock waves are not only a local, limited therapeutical instrument, I promise, yeah, but also a systemic therapeutical instrument, and it's non-specific. It's always suspicious if a medical method is non-specific, because then the indications become unbelievable. But we don't treat diseases. We treat only the symptoms in a certain way I described. Therefore, we have a lot of indications, even a tennis elbow, and that is a software problem of muscles. The stretches and the flexors are in disbalance. So we treat the flexors and the extensors, and not locally. We treat the flexors and extensors, and then we have pain relief. Let's see. A little bit better here. Why? Go the wrong way. The wrists. I referred to the false labeling. Shock waves of the radial manner are pressure waves and not shock waves. And in this context, it's important because radial shock waves provoke bleedings in the brain of rats. We don't try it in humans. And they provoke also bleedings in the lungs of dogs. Therefore, we don't use it because of this danger. Focused shock waves with an energy flux density below 0.25 are not provoking undesired symptoms, pain or something like that. That may be, but not serious symptoms. And that was proven by Manganotti from Parma in Italy, who did it with young men, volunteers. He treated the brain of those men and with these energies, and there was in the neurophysiological measurements and neither in the structural MRI something to see what could be a change of anything. Therefore we want stimulation, but we don't want the irritation. Avoid pain. It's like driving a car. Less gas. That is the secret. If a shockwave causes pain, provokes pain, something went wrong. Less energy, and it won't hurt. And the other side, shockwaves on painful or sensitive organs are painful, therefore less gas. I would receive without any problem one slap in the face, but not 1,000 on the same location. Therefore, we move the shockwave source constantly. Now I show you the paraplegic patients, 8 cases and of traumatic paraplegia and 2 cases of myelomeningocele. We treated them during the years. The treatment of with shockwaves was embedded in a complex therapy of physiotherapy, massage, medical, mechanical exercises like vibration systems, treadmills, and so on. We did the documentation with surface EMG because we have no money to do a needle EMG or something like that. With manual muscle test and functional reach test in sitting. I know the test is made for patients while standing, but we do it in the wheelchair too. It's really the same. Because we only, in what we do, we only treat off-label. That means patients where other methods of treatments fail or give no more progress. Then in Germany, we are able to say after informed consent, after paperwork and paperwork, we can treat patients without permission of the ethical committee. So the ethical committee waived the permission and said, it's not interested for us. For you, the limit is 10 to 12 patients. Then they are interested. Below 10, 12 patients, they are not interested. So, we treat 2 regions. It's around the lesion, around the fracture. No. Around the fracture. That means this region we treat. In myelomeningocele, this is the the level of the paralysis is Th12. It's Th12, it's here, and we treat the yellow region, constantly moving the therapy source and the foot soles, the peripheral structures. Why the foot soles, the quadratus muscle of the foot? Because they are densely innervated. There's a nerve supply which is like interossean in lumbricalis of the hand or the rectus oculi. We want to stimulate, and therefore we search the regions with most nerve supply. So you may play with the shockwave treatments. This is a TH10 fracture 6 years ago, and you see here the Babinski and the Clonus. You will see it. So Babinski very pronounced, and the anchors close. Here's only one answer. So, I treated only the left soul, only the left. Immediately after the treatment, you see, Babinski is fallen asleep. At the right side, he's still there. Now I treat also the right soul. Babinski is mute on the right side. The patient is a little bit surprised. You see the hand there? And then it's mute too. Two answers, one answer. So, 5 days later, the same patient, before treatment, we have the Babinski. It's not a miracle. And there we have the clones on the right side. Now, I only treat the perispinal region, not the foot, only the spine. The result is what you can see. Therefore, we have always to treat both regions, central and peripheral. This is from Paolo Marinotti from Verona, from Italy, a neurophysiologist. You see the clones on the left side, and 20 minutes later, an EMG of the right side. That is one case of neurophysiology. So, this is a traumatic paraplegia, TH10, after 20 years ago. And the problem was the peroneus, the paralysis of the peroneus to lift the forefoot. And you see here the surface EMG at baseline. There's no activity. And after 6 sessions of shockwave therapy, you see here the yes, point is not the best. You see that there is activity, and after some weeks it was an activity, not only an electrical activity, but also an activity that the patient could use. This is a TH5 fracture 3 years after the accident. It is a total one. And you see a patient sitting in a wheelchair and the trunk bent forward. And he's not able to straighten the trunk, and he's not able to stretch the knee or to find the knee stretcher, the extensor. And after now, it's a time of nearly 3 years with several complex therapy sessions. You see that there is an electrical activity in L4, L5, and the patient is able to straighten the trunk after being bent forward. And you see on the right foot, the first right leg, the first activity of the quadriceps rectus. On the left side, it's very poor, but it's beginning. The results, we observed 22 muscles in these patients, which were poorly or not at all innervated, and they showed all an increasing surface EMG activity and an average improvement in the manual muscular tests of 2.5 points. The functional reach test, that means finding the erector spinae, was better by, in average, 8.5 centimeters. and the deep and superficial sensibility was better. You see, now 30 years ago, girl with Milo Beninos here, and she tries to kick the ball. And you see, she's doing it with a trunk. It's a facial activity. She's doing it with a trunk. She doesn't find the quadriceps muscles. And after 2 years and three complex therapy series, this is the picture then. She didn't lose it anymore. She's able to use the quadriceps. She can't stand. But this is the result. And at the right side, she can do it too. Yeah. She's very proud of it. And the father in the background is proud too. So, this is a citation of Professor Wang from Beijing. You can read it by yourself. He found it out treating rats. But it's the same in humans. It's another thing. It's not a paraplegic, but it's a paraneuropathy, non-classified after 3 weeks. And six sessions with shockwave therapy on the spine. And that is the result from my salad. Try it. Please do it. It's a joy to do it. And the patients are really grateful afterwards. Start Monday morning. If you don't start Monday morning, you will never do it. And that's a short way. Thank you.
Thank you. That is a very interesting and very impressive lectures. Is there any questions from our audience?
Okay, I'm Dr. Yu from Ida Hospital, Kaohsiung, Taiwan. And first, just to say that this procedure, the shockwave for the paraplegic patient, is an off-label procedure, and the prognosis is not predictable. So, depends on patient. Should the patient need paid for money for this unpredictable procedure?
First, it's only one section. We have treated, and not only me, also patients with apathic syndrome and other pathologies. If we do research, the patients won't pay anything. First, I don't want to be a magic making money with these things. On the other hand, it was really legal what I did because I asked the ethical committee. And the third point was, it is predictable if you look on the physics. If you have a low energy and you have all those serious hundreds of investigations with rats and with high energy too, then you have to believe it's always a little bit insecurity in it, but you have to believe that it won't provoke damage. It's not fallen from heaven. Behind there is a lot of literature proving it, that it won't cause damage. It doesn't cause pain, for instance. That is would be a signal. But I mean, they don't feel pain. Shockwaves, which are painful, are not the good indication. Something went wrong. If you use shockwaves, even in the shoulder, if you cause pain, it was wrong. Too much energy. Go back to 0.01 and don't start with 0.1 or some colleagues say, more power, it will help better. No, it won't. It won't. Love energy. That's the secret.
Okay. And my second question is, how do you make the decision for perform the shockwave side? About the peripheral only, or region side only, or above the region side?
I didn't catch that because we have that microphone and I have another one.
Oh, okay. But how do you make the decision where should we perform the shockwave?
Where?
The where?
Yeah.
Region side or above region side or peripheral only?
Around in paraplegic, around the region. I want to stimulate the spinal cord in his whole, not puncture. Up and down, up and down, zigzag, 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 up and down. Aiming always in oblique to the spine and to the nerve roots. Stimulation, stimulation, stimulation. And then stimulation from the peripheral structures, foot circle. That is, I confess, that is the error of today. I started it that way. Tomorrow, better people than me started the other way around and have better results. But this is really the error of today. Tomorrow we know better.
Thank you. And we allow for the last question from Dr. Warren.
Yeah. You said that if you provide the chalk web to the patient, I need to maybe have the interval between the each section. So you can provide the patient continuously of chalk web. Because you say that you give the chalk web low energy, right? So can you make that chalk web continuously into the body of the patient, then the patient can get better faster and recover faster? Possible?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't know. The experience is the error of today. Tomorrow, somebody will make better.
Okay.
I only know, from my experience only, the grass won't grow faster if you tear it. More than 2 or 3 week series are useless. You don't have better results. 2 weeks is the best. Treating Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 6 times in 2 weeks. That is my experience. And not more. Not treating 6 weeks, 8 weeks, or I don't know. It's useless.
I am thinking about the tendons. The tendons, you know, the 10 times cutaneous, the electrical stimulation, patient can get that one at home and then they can continue to use it. So if your philosophy is good, why don't we use that continuously at home?
My job was to refer on shockwaves.
I am talking about shockwaves.
And the other methods we don't use. It's easy.
Thank you very much. That's a lot of support here. The paper is already around the other room.